Why are you going to the airport? Flying somewhere? Who is going to the airport, Jim? Are you going to the airport? So, I guess I should turn my volume down, huh? That would make sense. So I changed my configuration. Hopefully the sound is okay. Let me know if it's not. Flynn asks a good question. Is this questions about YouTube, or is it questions from people who watch YouTube? Specifically questions about YouTube, and it's not, that's the only thing that we're going to talk about. We'll try to hit some fish questions and probably get a mix of both along the way. So, you know, Thursday is kind of a little more low key, so I figured, you know, we could talk about stuff that's not 100% fish related, since there's generally not as many people here. Hi Reef, hi Bookshelf, hi Dead Boy, Flynn, Jimmy, Sashimi Jimmy, Nisi, Allison, Jennifer, Sam. How's everyone doing? If I missed your name, nothing personal. There's a lot of people talking right now. Cole, how you doing, Cole? Tomorrow is Friday. Yes, this is going to be an exciting, busy weekend. Can't wait. Dumb and Dumber quote from Sashimi Bob. Leland Thomas, how you doing? Is that baby tears in the foreground picture behind you? Yes. Yeah, tomorrow's Friday. It doesn't really mean much for me, but it is Friday. Kaz Aquatics is here again? Holy smokes. That is three in a row. What kind of camera? So Tamara Simpson asks, what kind of camera should you start with? Big Fly Multimedia, thanks for the help last week. I really appreciate it. As far as what camera you should start with, the best camera you have on hand, whether it be a four-year-old cell phone or a $5,000 DSLR, the best camera you can get your hands on. And then always upgrade it if you can. But most cell phones now are a good starting point. If you're making videos with cell phones though, you're gonna get to a point where it becomes really hard to grow. Hey Bob, love those pork chops. You're welcome, Bob. Yeah, thanks a ton, Lon. I really do appreciate it. Native Fish Keepers, how you doing, buddy? How many cameras do you use? I use two cameras. One, not very often. So I have my knockoff GoPro camera for the few times that I decide to film underwater. And then I hate, and I don't know what I was even going for there. Oh, somebody said hate in chat. Triggered in my brain. But most of the time I use my point and click Panasonic HD camera. And that was a $450 camera that I got on Amazon warehouse deal for $350. Leland says, I hit the iPhone, I can't super chat. Yeah, that's kind of weird. I don't know why they can't figure that out. Have I worked with bamboo shrimp? Yes, I have three bamboo shrimp right now, Jacob. If you're looking for tips, I would not get them until you have a well-established aquarium, since they're filter feeders. You really need a lot of stuff in the water for them to feed off of. If you put them in brand new setup tanks, they generally don't do well. Bob, it's been a while. Oh, Caleb RC Crawlers. Yeah, it has been a while. Glad you can make it. Kinbacher says, Steamfoot Aquatics, how come I have 22 more subs than I thought I would get? Because I subscribed, that's why. I'm one of them. Jacob says, what's the biggest tank I have? It's 125 gallon. Ridiculous Fish Adventures, good morning to you. Bob, if you could give one tip to a new YouTuber, what would it be? Boy, just one. Probably upload consistency. So if you're doing, whether you're doing a video a day, a video a week, or one video a month, make sure you're doing it. Make sure you're releasing it at the same time every time. Once you get to a point where you can start playing with it, I'm sure a lot of you people have noticed that you people, I don't know why I said that, but like I've been changing my release time because I'm trying to get analytics based on different times I release. So like I switched to 8 o'clock for a little bit. My last one was at 7 o'clock. I used to release at 4 o'clock. So, and it's my channel is definitely suffering for it. So that's why be consistent. Jack says, until you get the 240 up and running. Yep, hopefully, I'm not even going to say. I probably should have stopped the chat. A.B. Yes, I've been seeing you around a lot lately. You're definitely become part of the community. He's the head aquarist, I guess is what they call it, at a Petco. And the only Petco I've ever heard of that has brackish tanks, amazingly. So Jacob says, how long would you say I should cycle a tank before putting bamboo shrimp in? So I think there's a big difference between like an established tank or a seasoned tank versus a cycle tank. Because it only takes, 4 to 6 weeks to cycle an aquarium from scratch. Honestly, I would probably wait 6 months. Now there's things you can do because they're going to be really hard to feed. So it really depends on how much work you want to do. But if you really wanted to do the best you could do, I would probably wait like 6 months. What would you change about YouTube if I could? Tyler, I would want more transparency from YouTube. They tell us nothing. Michael says, putting driftwood with peacock's haps with cichlid sand, would my pH drop 7.4 out of the tap? Possibly. Depends on how much you put in. No, today's upload was re-uploaded. Cool88 Luke. Every time I see your name, all I can think of is Cool Hand Luke. Either way, pretty awesome name. Ringo Starr says, is Corey in Japan? Nope. Nope. It's rough starting off. Stupid Niners, why didn't they leave last game? Let's see. I think Bob is like Joe Dirt, except with a hat instead of a mullet. I don't know who Joe Dirt is. I know it's a movie, but I've never seen it. All About DIY says, what do you think about Joey's GoFundMe deal? $95,000 in 2 days. Crazy. You should check my last live stream on Tuesday. I did a nice big rant about his GoFundMe. And you could probably skip ahead to maybe like the 15-20 minute mark. Somewhere in there, I think, is when that subject came up. Leland says, I wish that between you or Corey or Lucas or Robert would ship to Canada. Yeah, that's everyone's wish, my friend. Communication is not very important anywhere anymore, it seems. Workplaces are getting horrible. Yeah, it's kind of amazing. Like, we have the most ways ever to communicate, and no one communicates. They're too busy on their phone, ironically enough, to communicate. I always find it kind of sad when you go out to a restaurant and you see a couple and they're not even talking, they're not even looking at each other. They're just buried in their phones. Like, what's the point? All About DIY says, still can't find Cyprochromis Bob. Go to cichlidlovers.com. I'll type it out for you. I swear this is an actual site, not anything devious. Go there. Last time I checked, he did have some Cyprochromis for sale, and they're like $12. The only caveat is that he'll only ship them air cargo. No matter how much you beg and pay, only air cargo. But I'm going to see if he still has them. Just for you. Just because I love Cyprochromis. If I could type. Trying to be a 49ers fan in Chicago. Okay, just looking at this list real quick. We'll scroll down to... Oh, so the Cyprochromis Leptosoma Jumbo Blackfin are the same ones I bought from him. So I haven't done an update video on them in a very long time, but if you go way back on my channel, you'll see them, and I still have them, and they're doing great. And at $12, you can't really beat it. So there you go. And he's a breeder, so they're all bred in his facility down in Arizona. I will tell you the air cargo for me from Arizona to here was only $50, so I mean almost the same price, if not cheaper, than overnight. Oh, Short and Anxious is here. Just tired for my first day off. Glad you can make it, Short. Glad you got a day off and everyone's been missing you. Okay, here we are. How to get Elocaris parvula to carpet. Mine only sends runners upwards. Josh, if your plants are only sending runners up, that probably means you need more light because they're trying to get to the light. That being said, I don't think I've kept that plant. Wait, yes I have. Let me double check. I'm not really the best when it comes to scientific names for plants. Oh, dwarf hairgrass? Oh, yeah, you probably need more light. Dwarf hairgrass can be difficult without CO2 as well, but it can be done because I'm doing it. Hey Bob, did you get my email for the background for a live stream? I haven't checked my email today, but I almost used your old one. I almost used it. It was between yours and this one, and I pretty much just flipped a coin. We landed on the moon! The thing I would change about YouTube is to have more Bob on YouTube. I don't think YouTube could handle more of me. Bob, it's been a while. How's everything? The dirty tank looks great. Everything is doing great. Everything is doing really well. Thank you. If you could recommend one pleco for an advanced fish keeper, which one would you say? I don't know if I could recommend just one. You mean like you're only going to keep one pleco or one species? Jason, no holds barred. High, Short, and Anxious. Would you say collaborations are one of the fastest ways to growing subscriptions? How important are iCards? What the heck is an iCard? Are you talking about just the cards? Let's look. Let's look, Sashimi Jimmy, and I think collaborations, depending on what you want out of your channel, are very good. I have no idea what's going on. I got a new phone, and yeah, still learning it. So, the first thing you need to get is the YouTube Studio app. If you're uploading videos and you don't have this app, you need to get it. And we're gonna go to analytics. Let's see, and interactive content. So clicks per card shown. Basically, every time there's a card shown, it gets clicked on 8.1%, so 8%. And I would say, I don't know if that's good or not, but I would say it's pretty important because that's 8% more people clicking on your content. So I would at least put one in every video. And I do. I do. I put at least one. 19 rainbow sharks died in a 25-gallon selling tank. We had an adult and 19 juveniles. I didn't order 20, I ordered 7 for the 7 tanks they can occupy, but my boss wanted all 20 in the same tank. That sounds like a disaster waiting to happen. Poor fish. Doesn't sound like that's what you wanted though, but I think that's kind of the problem with the corporate pet stores, right? Like the Petco by my store, I don't know if this is true for all by my store, but the Petco by my house, they're not allowed to medicate fish. They're just supposed to let them die. Short and Anxious says, Bob ranted on Joey's GoFundMe. I missed that. Yes, Monday. Why did I say Tuesday? My Monday live stream. I want to say it was about at the 15 or 20 minute mark. I don't remember. But yeah, both Corey and I kind of touched base on that. I sent in a new updated one for my 55-gallon today. Since my last one I submitted, I've upgraded to Fluval 2.0 and injected CO2. Oh, awesome. Yeah, I usually don't check my Steamflat Aquatics Gmail until night. So, usually once a day at night. Hey Bob, do you have any experience with Pictus cats? I have been considering doing a catfish 75. I was wondering on your thoughts. I love Pictus catfish, but I don't keep them because they're very food aggressive. Not even aggressive. So they're not mean. They're just super fast. And so they're awesome to watch. But if you have other bottom dwellers, they're not going to get any food. So I would say if you do Pictus cat, make sure that you're not doing like Corys or even Plecos. Steamflat Aquatics, do you have any Hank Hill with your shirt on part 2 for my weird suggestions? Hank Hill with your shirt on. Oh, yeah, I remember. Oh, that reminds me. I should check on that. I don't know if that's still up. Let's see. I actually made it so you guys could order shirts online instead of... Yeah, it's still here. So if anyone wants a shirt... it's a little bit more expensive because I'm going through a third-party seller, but there you go. There's a few more options, which is nice. I don't know why that's not working, though. Looks like I'll have to look at that afterwards. I run 8 LEDs on a 5-gallon, so what else could it be? It could still be lighting. If your plants are growing tall instead of wide, it's lighting. You might have the wrong Kelvin rating. That's pretty much a general rule for all plants. Hello, if you have 3 tanks, should I have 3 different pythons and water pumps to do water changes? Will I cross-contaminate? I don't know of anyone that does that. It's obviously better, but I feel like if you're keeping healthy fish, then the risk is pretty minimum. I have 30 tanks, and I use the same pump in each tank, so. Short says, okay, I'll have to check that out. Joey's not very popular in this camp as it is, so I will check it out. He has not been very nice to me, so love to hear this rant. You're probably going to be disappointed. Bob, bring back the Rick. Yeah, I kind of gave up. Kind of gave up on that. Steamflat Aquatics missed a super chat, and Bob, I did some digging on the site and I was wrong. We do have to pay for our own shipping from Peru. Oh. Well, it's all part of the budget. Did I miss a super chat? Oh, there we go. Sorry about that. Born to keep fish. Hello, fish fam. Love the Big Steen rants. Well, good. I'm glad somebody does. DPK says, hit that like button and help fund tanks for teachers. It's a great cause. Everyone, let's make a difference. Yep. And I'm looking for I'm looking into another organization as well. So we'll see how that goes. Well, not as well, because this is not an organization. This is just doing my own thing. But if I record in HD, can I export it as 4K for the background video? As long as your software can do it, yeah, absolutely. 4K would be even better. It'd make my green screen, even though it looks pretty good, like I can see where it doesn't look good. Bob, are you really 50 years old? No, I'm not 50. Exactly. Hiya, Jeremy. Sergeant? Oh, Sergeant Tank is here. How you doing, buddy? Hey, Bob, if you're ever through this this place in Indiana, you should check out Inland Aquatics, over 30,000 gallons of reef and freshwater. Wow. Indiana, huh? Maybe. I mean, we're going to Chicago. Not that far away. Charles Fish Tank says, my collab with Bob definitely helped me grow fast. So, here's the thing. If for the people who are around, like in November and December, kind of my big thing was doing collabs with other, like, smaller channels. And I'll try not to turn this into a rant, but you'll notice that I've kind of gone away from that because I get people messaging me all the time that want to do a collab, they want to come on the live stream, And I'm like, okay, well, I'll look at your channel and I'll do the shout out thing and we'll get you a few subscribers. We'll see how it goes. And then after a month, they just disappear. And they don't upload a video ever again. And I'm like, well, now I just wasted all this time on someone who was not serious at all. Because they always message me like, I really want to be on YouTube and I really want a fish channel. And, you know, it's like my dream. And then they don't get the results that you're looking for or that they're looking for. And they just give up after like a month or two. So now when people message me and want to collab, I'm like, okay, well, let's put it on the schedule. I'll give you like 3-4 months. And if you're consistent, then yes, I can collab. But I think there was like 3 or 4 people in a row who I shouted out and talked about on the live stream, and they just quit after like a month. So anyways, that makes me a bad person. I'm sorry, but don't tell me that like this is your dream and then give up on your dream after a month. That's all I'm saying. Pictus Cats, yes, I already answered that question. For you science nerds, it's the 25th anniversary of the first image of the cosmic microwave background. Now back to work. I love space. I am a space nerd. That's one of the things, probably one of the only other things I watch on YouTube. Definitely like space stuff. My rainbow shark got huge. Luckily for me, it liked to stay in its plants all the time. Nice. I feel like I'm way behind. Steamfight Aquatics. Oh, I'm way behind because I scrolled back up. Fish Bossman, thanks. Says, thank you for inspiring me from your last stream to make my first YouTube video. I won't let the community down. Thank you, Fish Bossman. And let's see. I saw your comment. And I haven't watched it yet. But I will. I'll leave it up so I'll watch your first video. It's one of my favorite things is watching people's first video. YouTube is something you gotta do for yourself, in my opinion. The channel growth is inspiring and cool, but that's not what it should be completely about. It should be a drive to do more and do better. Yep, absolutely bare necessity. Who has got the best thumbnails ever? Steamfight Aquatics, why is it when I'm researching a type of fish, I might like to have some look really good, some really bad genetics, or what? Wait. Why is it when I'm researching a type of fish, I might like to have some look really good, some look really bad? I mean, bad genetics and care level definitely play into like the colors of fish. Whether fish are spawning or not. So, you know, there's a lot of fish that'll get really fired up and colorful when they're trying to mate. So that could be it. The age of the fish could be another thing. The collection point where the fish is actually collected could be another reason. Let's see, I just skipped through like a bunch of them. And thanks a lot, Fish Bossman. We really appreciate it. Stacked up so I have more to upload when I run out of ideas. Evening Bob. Hello, Sharon. Kaz Aquatic says, this is why I personally set the channel up and upload a single video as a preview of what you can expect, and then work on a bunch of videos. Don't start uploading until I have a bunch. Alan said, if I had a 500-gallon, I'd put 500 autosynclus in it. What would you put in a huge tank? Probably my Mabu Puffer. And a nice school of rainbow fish. Although it would be kind of a chore to feed my puffer if I had a big school. I'm still here, Bob. Always be here watching, waiting for the right moment to strike. And no, that doesn't make you a bad person. Good. Glad someone thinks so. Steamfight Aquatics, hey brother, got a question. My convict female always eats her fry within a day or two of the eggs turning into wigglers. Why is that? Surely they're not ready to breed again yet. How many spawns has she had? She still might be learning. I've never kept convicts, but I know, like, with apistos and some, like, German rams and other cichlids just in general, they always eat the first couple batches because they don't know any better. But they usually learn. They usually pick it up. Caleb's RC Crawler said, I started my YouTube channel to show people what can be done in the RC hobby just for fun. Yeah, there's always this transition period, and it keeps skipping. So where was that? Okay, I haven't got to your comment yet. I think we're right around here. Oh yeah, right here. So there's always this transition period where people do it for fun, and then they have so much fun that they want to make it, they want to make it their career. And it's really easy to do that. I think a lot of people would be really surprised on how few subscribers it really takes to make YouTube, and when I say YouTube, I'm just mean social media in general, your career. There's a lot of people that do it at around 1500 subscribers, and the people that say, what, how is that even possible, those are the people that haven't researched it enough. So yeah, Steamfight Aquatics, you make me blush. You're, well, yeah, your thumbnails make me angry because I can't do that. And thumbnails is like something that I really need to focus on because mine are really bad, but I'm still learning. That's something I'm working on. How do you feel about my process? I have like 5 videos stacked up right now. As long as you're releasing on the same time at the same day, then I think you're good. I wouldn't get like 5 videos stacked up and then release like all 5 of them, like every day, release a new video, and then wait like 2 weeks and do it again. Steamfight Aquatics, can you rant at Niecy for not making me food? I can't, because she said she would feed me if I ever came to Alaska, so I can't burn that bridge. Bob, what is your biggest YouTube pet peeve? Kind of what I said before, and that's YouTube not communicating with creators as far as changes they're making. And so there's always this guessing game. Basically, the algorithm always changes, and yeah, we shouldn't know the algorithm, but we should have a little bit of information on what they're looking for and what they want. It's always this continuing, evolving process that no one ever knows. Bob, what do I think about American Aquarium Supply? Any reviews? I don't know that I've ever gotten anything from them. Let me Google them. Guess I'll have to Google it. American Aquarium Products. For the serious freshwater marine and pond keeper. Yeah, I've never bought anything from here, so I can't give an opinion. Their website looks like it was built in 1994, though. I can't say that. Leland says, do you have a problem with Joey? I'm confused. No. So when I say rant doesn't mean a bad thing. That just means that we talked about it and we ranted about it. Yeah. Sashimi Whiskey says, yeah, it's a rant. It's a rant isn't a negative thing. It can be. Steamfight Aquatics, I recently planted a dwarf. Did everyone just go leave? Did everyone just leave the live stream to go look at my rant? How many people do we have? Oh crap, we're at almost 200. That's almost a record for a Thursday. 80 likes, only 20 more likes to go. I recently planted dwarf Sagittaria with normal dirt gravel around the base. Is that okay? Yep. It's not like a crypt plant where the crown needs to be out of the substrate, so you should be just fine. I've got a planted 40 breeder tank with Crips, Anubias, Java Fern, Java Moss. What light would you recommend for fastest growth with ferts but without CO2? So here's your problem. You got probably the slowest growing plants available in the aquarium trade. So the other thing you got going is that they're the lowest light plants. So you don't need very much light. Blasting more light is not going to do you any good unless you do CO2. It really depends, because you can get away with like a cheap beams work on eBay for like $30. It'll grow those plants. I think the biggest problem you're going to have in a 40 breeder is the spread of the light, so you might want to get 2 light fixtures. Like, if it was me, I would get 2 Phoenix Stingray, 36-inch Phoenix Stingrays. But that's just me. Okay, let's see, where was that? No problem. Man, did I get way behind again? Hello, Caleb. Oh, Susan, I missed another super chat. Or I just haven't got to it yet. Susan for SLC Aquatics, what are your thoughts on Mopani driftwood? I've never used it in the aquarium, only for my reptiles. I mean, I know people use it, but I feel like I would get Malaysian driftwood over Mopani driftwood if I was buying driftwood. Because Malaysian driftwood is awesome. Now, where was I? Oh, here we got the follow-up to the convict. She's a young cichlid. Yeah, that's probably why. That's probably why she's eating her own young. Oh, hi all, just popping in to say hi. Busy day at work. Hello, Joel. Speaking of food, I'll listen while I can. Yep, she must be cooking. It was a rant against people who've been bashing the GoFundMe. Yeah, there we go. So, I guess, dog hair. I was wrestling with my dog before the live stream. Now it's like all over me. The best and worst thing for the aquarium community is Facebook groups. It can be great, but man alive, can it be cancer? Yes. So I've actually had to delete people out of my Facebook group, like permanently ban people last week for the first time. So that was kind of fun. Man, how far back? Drop show, you can contact me at any time. Here we go. I think I was right here. Yep. The GoFundMe for DIY education as a hobby is invaluable. We need to support one another. Yep. I don't want to spend too much time on Joey because we spent a lot of time on it on Monday. Let's get through some of these comments. Okay, I was there. Susan for SLC Aquatics. Now, I will tell you that something that YouTube, if you want to get on YouTube, look at Susan for SLC Aquatics. She's a small channel. She just hit 300 subscribers. But she's doing things right in key areas. For instance, she's doing a lot of live streamings, which is not... Live streaming is not good for growth at all. But the quality of the live stream is there. So that's one of the biggest hiccups I think a lot of the smaller channels are having right now, is they're live streaming with like 8-bit cameras. And a lot of people, and I found this out, a lot of people hate poor quality cameras. And I didn't have... So I had a little bit of growth, but I didn't get the real growth until I got my new camera. So it's very important. So Susan is definitely doing that right. And this is not a knock on Susan, but I feel like if Susan can do it right, then everyone can do it right. And that's meant as a compliment. I hope you take it that way, Susan. Bob, you only play my terrible videos as a joke to embarrass me. I don't think that counts. Not that I have a good video on my channel that I wouldn't be embarrassed about, but still. Sure, I played one video of yours once on my live stream because I think it was your first video, if I remember right. I might be remembering that wrong, but it certainly was not to embarrass you. I do a lot of people's first videos live. I just want to learn how to do bordered font for my thumbnails. You should. What do I use? I use TubeBuddy. I think TubeBuddy does it. No. One of the tools I use, Sam, does it, and I'll get back to you on that. I don't remember. I have too many. Do plecos do well in planted tanks, especially carpet plants? Most will. You shouldn't have a problem. V-Stag? Thoughts on sponge filters? Josh Job, I think they're the greatest. I use Photoshop for my thumbnails. Yeah, that's my problem, is I don't have Photoshop, for one. Two, I've tried Photoshop, and I'm terrible at it. but there are other applications that are out there that you could use that are cheaper. Yeah, Bare Necessities, I've been trying to learn GIMP. So GIMP is basically a free version of Photoshop. And that's very simplistic way to put it. But it's a photo editor that's free. It's GIMP, G-I-M-P. Sanchez got a new tank. Occasional, yes, I have been. It was my kid's favorite restaurant for a while. Okay, I'd like to upgrade my camera, but I would probably only go with high quality ones like the Canon T6i or something, but then that'll get really expensive. So the thing you got to think about is it going to be worth it for the long-term success of your channel? Like, do you want your channel, like, what do you want out of your channel? I guess is what you would have to ask and answer to see if it's worth the price of that camera. Because I see a lot of people, so here's the thing. I see a lot of people that say, "What kind of camera do I need for YouTube?" And a lot of people say, "Oh, just use your iPhone. Just use your camera. It's good enough." Well, it's not. How many big channels or successful channels do you guys watch where they're filming with a phone? And yes, some of their videos, like on the fly, are filled with phones, but I can't think of any channel that's successfully or big that films with a phone. So that's the advice I would never listen to. And I'm sorry if you've said that and that I just offended you because you have said that, but it's truth. I mean, that's truth. I like to rant about my guppies. That doesn't mean it's a bad thing. What did you get at Corey's house, Flynn? I forgot to ask. Gently stroke the like button. Ooh, up to 120. Did my channel just show my fish? Oh, I did my channel just to show my fish and why I love them. And now, David, you're part of the family. You're hooked. All right, I need to try to get to the end here. Let's see. Let's make sure I didn't miss any more super chats. Apparently, that's my thing today. Okay, Bob, would bristlenose plecos eat Corydora eggs? Probably. If they didn't eat them, they would probably ruin them. Bob, if you're not tired, you better liven it up, or I'm going to have to go back to my housework. No, this is as good as it gets. So back to work. Susan's streams are great. Yes, Susan has a great stream. Backhanded compliment, LOL joke. Bob, would you say my MacBook camera is adequate enough? For what? For your live streams? Is it common for rainbow fish to lose scales on shipping? I've never had one do that. So I would say no. KG Cichlids loves poor quality. Oh man. Aqua Apprentice says Reefapalooza is coming. Is anybody going? I am not. Bob, what's the best food to bring out reds and fish? I don't know. I've never noticed a difference on any of that color enhancing food. So I don't know. I can't really say. What's good? Been listening on my TV for a while I mess with my tanks. Nerdy fish. Everything's good. What air pump for a high flow and 180 gallon sponge filter? I've never heard of a 180 gallon sponge filter, but things to take into consideration is the size and how deep the tank is. The deeper the tank, the more air pressure you're going to need. Only joking, Bob. I know, short. I know. Sorry, I'm late. Hello, everyone. Hello, Gribble Grumble. Flynn's Fish Forum. Hey, buddy, I saw a red color promoting food the other day from a brand I love, but I don't remember if it was New Life Spectrum. It was probably New Life Spectrum, and I've tried it, and I didn't notice a difference. So, I don't know. Bob, if you could only keep one 33-gallon community tank, what would you keep? So, I have a 33-gallon, and I hope you're talking about the 33-gallon long, the 4-foot tank, because that's the only one that I know of. It's not going to be the best community tank, but I would do like a Hillstream Loach setup, like a stream tank, and Hillstream Loaches and gobies. I think that would be awesome. Gimp is a tall tree to climb. Gimp is a tall tree to climb, too. Hi, Bob, and all you tankers. Hello, Rob Hicks. Cape Cod is nice. Isn't Gimp what the girls use to make bracelets? I have no idea what you guys are talking about. Flint's Fish Farm foods with a lot of carotenoids. Lots of dry foods have it. Dry from krill, salmon. Yeah, most of them have krill in it for the red. My local fish store is whack, whack. So I really cannot get any money for the guppies. So I'm getting bigger, more colorful species for my 55-gallon. Awesome. Let's see. Smash the like button. gimp.oil. I don't know. I'm gonna have to go back and watch and try to figure out what you guys are talking about. Oh man, just skipped through everything, but luckily I was at all the emojis, so it should be easy to find. There we go. H2O uses a phone. Yep. Hey guys, listening on the line. Yes, but H2O is talking about getting a new camera, so I think that'll help his channel a lot. Hi everybody, can somebody please give me a few suggestions on how to eliminate white fuzzy fungus growing on my cholo wood and java moss in my shrimp tank? Well, it's probably just growing on the wood and probably falling off and getting into your java moss. That's one of the things I don't like about java moss, is it's like a dustpan, or like a just a big dust bunny. It collects all the debris. But you could get like a bristlenose pleco or maybe some autosynclus, and they'll actually eat that white fungus that comes off of the wood. And that's probably honestly going to last for like 2 to 3 months before all of that stops. I do it for fun and use my phone. That's what makes it a hobby. Yep. Again, I'm not bashing people. What I'm talking about is the people that say they're serious about growing their YouTube channel and just want to do it with a phone. Bob, I get a like for answering me. I think to start, a smartphone is good, but we'll need some upgrading at some point. Yep. It's an excellent starting point, but if you ever want to get to that next echelon or that next tier, you're definitely going to want a real camera. Bob, can longfin green dragon plecos with spots still be classified as green dragons? Yep. Mine have spots on them. iPhone 7 Plus video quality is a lot better now. Not much left for fish stores. All right, yeah, I got to upgrade to a legit camera, but I don't want to because I'm cheap. Yeah, I know how that goes. See, the trick is to get good enough on YouTube with just your camera that you start making a little extra income and then save that up and buy a camera. That's what I did. Singapore is such a small place for the fish hobbies. Nice to see fish community here. Singapore. I think I'd like to go there someday. For the background video, would you care if I switch between two cameras every 5 minutes on the same tank? Nope. As long as they're like hard shifts, so it's like instant. No like walking or moving, and I don't mind that, but a lot of people hate that. Bob, for shame, you can be more lively than this, but of course this is not the Saturday night goofy live stream. Yep. This is the Thursday night low-key live stream short. This is my low-key, although for some reason tonight it's not very low-key because we're at 185 people. At Corey's house, I got a trio of Liberty Mollies, awesome. My Stirby breeding group, awesome. An aquarium co-op towel, even I don't have that yet. How's that even possible? And something very special and generous, you will see the jump in quality in my video. Yep, I know what you got, Flynn. You're lucky I didn't steal that first. I asked to borrow it, but I knew what was happening, so I couldn't. Flynn, how old are you? So need to check out Susan's live streams. Primetime Aquatics, I would highly recommend checking out Susan for SLC Aquatics live stream. They're on the smaller side, so they're a little more intimate and just an all around good time. Hello Flynn, can't wait to see your quarries from Corey. What do you know about Apistos, Bob? I'm certainly not an expert, but I've kept and bred them. What do you want to know? The latest phones paired with great editing and presentation can make a great YouTube channel, but eventually it needs that upgrade, like Bob said. Yep, absolutely. Where is the Seattle Seahawks hat? Has Bob been abducted by aliens and it didn't hit social media? I hardly ever wear that hat. I don't have time for football anymore. That's the problem. Where is that comment? Michael's Fish Room is here. How you doing, buddy? Let's see. Hi, Michael. Man, I'm going fast. I'm still way behind. Okay, Seafon Aquatics, can I keep a plastic breeding tube outside for koi? Can I keep a plastic breeding tube outside for koi? I live in Illinois. Please help. I've never kept koi. I'm certainly not an expert, but I know they can last in pretty cold weather. Sup, Steamboat? Sup, Michael? Bob, I'm live tonight. Stop by. It's always a pleasure to have you in the chat. I'll try, but once I'm done on this live stream, I'll probably be working till about 11 o'clock. My buddy just sent me 4 orange dwarf crayfish, like 20 red ram's horn, and a mono, and nerite, some frog bit, a bunch of stuff. You got a bunch of stuff for a 30-gallon tank, and I think they're all going to work well together. I'd be pretty excited, too. Especially for the dwarf orange crayfish. Anything die in there? Feeding schedule change? Okay, people helping people out. I appreciate that. I'll probably be getting a refurbished Canon DSLR as my first high-quality camera, like Bare Necessities recommended. Yep, I want to try the new Sony Mark V, but it's very expensive. Let's see. Can I download this stream and sample when you said whack? That's whack. Sashimi Whiskey, I probably just lost 10 subscribers by saying that. Sashimi Whiskey, you're going to have to match Corey's business-related streams with editing skills streams. He said he was going to do that, but I think he's too busy. Okay, let's see. I already got to that question. Susan, of course, much love. It's 2 feet deep. What air pump would work best for a 180-gallon sponge filter? What's the size? Like, I've never heard of a 180-gallon sponge filter. My work Wi-Fi is slow. I'll catch the rest in Memorex. All right, Jennifer, thanks for stopping by. What food do I recommend for mollies? I've never kept a molly in my life. Favorite ancestress? I can't say that I have a favorite, but probably the longfin green dragon. Is the wave sound playing on purpose? What wave sound? Oh, there you go. Why do you wait till 50 minutes to point that out? Man, people are slacking. You're supposed to let me know a background noise at the start. My bristlenose pleco is really picky at food. That's strange. Have you tried like cucumber and like zucchini or green beans? Josh Job, a Whisper 40 yeah. So I guess, not knowing much about your sponge filter size, things like that, I love the Whisper Pump Tetra filters. Pretty much the only ones I buy, besides like my big ones. High key is the new low key. Singapore is really hot and humid. Dress light here. it's because you're the boss. Did Flynn get something? Lost 10 subscribers, more like gained 10. So I just skipped a bunch of chats. Sorry about that. Looks like Rich's Fishes just started streaming too. I think I need to start paying attention to see if John goes live. Who asked about koi in Illinois? Oh yeah, Jason is from there, so he should be able to help you out. Let's see, I have my sights set on the Nikon D5300 for the price range and ability, but even 700 is a bit out of my reach. Yeah, don't go spending your Peru money. How about a 47-year-old white woman using the word whack? See, now that would be awesome. I still love you, Bob. Sweet, I still love you too, buddy. Crack is whack. What's a good video editing app? I use Filmora Wondershare. Super easy to learn. Gets the job done. They are better than Red Panda Bears. I think I just missed a whole bunch of chats too. Sorry about that. Have you seen a water bear? It lives in the vacuums of space and through nuclear winter. All right. Kenneth chiming in says, mollies can eat flake food and eat algae as well. Yep, absolutely. At least it's not the background noise of the fan this time. Short and anxious, you haven't been here in a long time. That's been fixed for at least a whole day now. The sponge size or the tank size? The sponge. I believe the sponge is 6 inches across and 3 up. And down the tank is a 40 breeder. I thought you said it was 2 feet deep. That's not a 40 breeder. Yeah, I would go with the Whisper 40. That's a great pump. Excellent suggestion. I like feeding more frozen. And okay, Bookshelf Aquatics, how many hats can you keep in a 10-gallon tank? So I'm really weird with my hats. A lot of people just assume I have a lot of hats, but I'm too cheap to have a lot of hats. So I usually buy like a hat or maybe two, and then I wear them until they break down, and then I'll buy another one. That's pretty much how I work. Shoes, everything the same way. I'm really cheap when it comes to clothing. Oh, that's bad, Bob. At least it's fixed. Yeah, sure. It's been fixed for like a week. At least my last three streams, I think. But how many? I don't know. You could probably get like 50 in there if you mash them up. But Bookshelf Aquatics, definitely check out the channel. Thanks for the $10 super chat. We really appreciate it. And Bob, I'm in the Pacific Northwest, same as you, I think. When would you put guppies outside to breed in a tub, a pond? Mike, I put guppies outside last week. We'll see how they do. Bare Necessities, Charles Fish Tank. I ended up getting the Canon G7X Mark I point and shoot for $300. It does pretty good with proper lighting, not too good with macro shots or darker shots. Yeah, I'll pretty much only buy point and shoots. I don't know that I'll ever get a DSLR. DNH, how you doing? Bob, are you still planning to get goldfish? What type of fancy goldfish do you like or are planning to get? I have no information that I'm willing to divulge at this point about what type of goldfish I'm getting, but I will say that I do plan on getting some goldfish. So in the thousands of years of your time on Earth, you've gone through thousands of hats? They usually last me about a year. Bob, I need urgent help. I have 37 Oscars, 42 Big Steniums, and 46 Cory Takaroys. Can they all go in a 10-gallon? Yep. Yep, they can. A lot more fun to buy plecos and hats, Bob. Yeah, like, I don't got money to waste on clothes. I'm not here to look good, clearly. Bob, when are you going to get angelfish? Very low on the list of fish that I want at this point. Well, 180-gallon rated. I would get off of the 180-gallon rated. That's all marketing. So would your sponge work in a 40-gallon breeder with 200 guppies? Yes, as long as you're doing your water changes. I will not be getting common goldfish. I will be getting fancy goldfish. Do you think that if the whisper pump would be okay outside if it's off the ground and covered from the rain? Yes, I do, Sunless Plain. I think it would be just fine. But if you're running a power cord outside, so if your power is coming from in your home, you're better at leaving the pump inside and running the air out, so that way you'll get the warm air of the house going outside. But if you're just plugging it in outside, then obviously that's a mute point. Guppies are really hardy. They're often found in the drains in my country. Yep, we'll see how they do. I haven't checked up on them yet. Bob, have you ever thought about using something like light egg crates for substrate filler so that you don't have to use as much substrate? I have thought about it, Kang Lee, and that's about as far as I've gone, is just thought about it. Yeah, get Arandas. See, I don't know enough about goldfish. Like, if you tell me to get an Aranda, I have no idea what that is. Except that I know it's a fancy pleco. That's all I know. Or a fancy goldfish. Yeah, get Arandas. I have a 75-gallon acrylic completely empty. List for me the substrate, plants, fish you would purchase. Thanks. I don't have time to get into that. We got 5 minutes left. Ask me on Monday earlier. And we'll see if I can get into that, because there's don't get what I would get. Find something you like. What are some general tips for Corydoras? I've never had much luck with them, no matter what I've done. Aquatic life, they're pretty easy fish, but you got to make sure you're feeding them. A lot of people will put them in community tanks with a lot of fish that hang out in the upper water column, and they pretty much get all the food before it makes it to the bottom. So, like most catfish, you really got to make sure that they're getting food. Bob, I want to add a Frontosa to my already established African cichlid. What can I do to avoid it getting murdered? Make sure it's going to be the same size as your other African cichlids, for one. And you could also, when you introduce it into the tank, you could rearrange like your hardscape. And so everyone has to establish new territories. LG3 Nation with the awesome super chat. $1.94. Thank you. Can always count on you for that. Bob, check your Facebook Messenger when the stream is over. Pretty please. Don't tell me you did it again. How about Ranchu Goldfish? I love them. Yeah, I don't know. Like I said, I know that they're called Arandas and Ranchu. And Blackmore. Okay, I do know Blackmore, and I will be getting one of those. I don't know why, but I think they're awesome. You know what's bad when your fish eat better than you do? Yeah. I resent the tank and tested the water. All things test fine. I got another fish and lost him 3 days later. He did not eat for me, though. Any ideas what could be wrong? Heidi, what are your parameters? So you say everything's fine, but I'm still curious what the parameters are. My corridors love flakes and wafers and water changes of cooler water. Yeah, you could get your... That's pretty much how you get your quarries to spawn, is doing cold water changes. Corridors do best in groups. Yep. So the internet will tell you that you need at least 3. I up that to 6. Need at least 6. Hey, Bob, how about hats off reveal for 10K? Nope. The deal was, and this was like back in December when I only had like 3,000 subscribers, the deal was 100,000. Nope, it's not Ashton Kutcher, it's Bob Steenfaught, equally handsome, equally smart. I don't know, that dude is surprisingly stupid smart. Like, he is really smart. They sell albino plecos for $15 to $20 on the freshwater. Really? 6 watchers away from 200, right when we're about ready to cut it off. I gotta bring up, I know KG Cichlids is probably paying attention. Big Fly Multimedia says, good night all. Good night, Lon. Thank you again. I really, really do appreciate it. KG Tropicals. Dude, my 1K subs by the end of the year. Yes. Make goals. Make goals. If you want to be successful on YouTube, make goals and actually follow through. So, if you want to be successful, make goals and at least do one thing every day to get you towards that goal. Okay. Got up his channel up here, so we'll see. Like gangsta smart. Yeah, it's like a weird mix of street and book smarts. It's pretty impressive. I guess you're just used to his character, or like me, used to his character on That 70s Show. So when you see him like talking in front of Congress, it's pretty amazing. Dean H says, take care, Bob. Have a wonderful weekend, man. Thank you, Dean. Really appreciate it. Heidi says, neutral pH, 0 nitrate, 0 nitrite, 0 ammonia. So, Heidi, if you don't have any nitrates, then your tank is not cycled yet. So I think that's what's going on. I can't make videos, spend too much time watching you, Corey, Brett, Joey, and everyone else. Yeah, it's really hard to keep up on everyone's channel. And I actually feel really bad for it. Bob, they all have goals. It's to be famous on YouTube. Didn't you hear yourself starting the goal? My goal has never been to be famous on YouTube. That's what everyone says. Like, I hate the people that say, oh, people just do YouTube to be famous or to be rich. Like, nobody is famous. There's not one famous YouTuber that's in the fish world. So I don't understand that statement. And there's not really one super rich YouTube either. So that's definitely not why people do it. Not cycled, or you have 10 pothos in there. Yep. What are some plants that are fast-growing water column feeders? Floating plants. Any floating plant. Whew. Favorite monster fish? Definitely my Mabu Puffer. I think that... I love your intros, by the way. I do, too. I think my Mabu Puffer can be a monster fish, right? It will be someday. Just refresh this. It is 601. Let's see. Primetime Aquatics, do you have an email? Heidi says, I want to go to a local fish store versus the big box stores, but there are none near me. Heidi, if you do go to your big box store, they'll still, like PetSmart, will test your water for you, and I would take your water in there just to get a second opinion. Short and Anxious says, you are not in a joking matter, Bob. Back to being point A to point B, Bob. Mood. Yep, I am actually feeling really focused today. I have a lot of things I want to get done, so I actually have a list here right in front of me. Bob, I don't know if you answered this earlier. What do you feed your Bosmani rainbow fish for best color? Do you plan on putting them out in a pond this summer? Nope, I will never put them out in a pond simply because I don't want to risk losing them to outside intruders because mine are from Gary Lang. So they're doing really well where they are, so they're going to stay there. And I feed them a mix of frozen, freeze-dried, and then flake every once in a while. What's a good plant for guppies? Guppy grass, Java moss. It's pretty much what I use. Lumpy D is in the house. Hey, Lump. Serious Bob, faces on then. Hey, I'm always up for a good joke, Short. But yeah. Let's see. C is for suspension. Your thoughts on the train scene with Doc's kid at the end of Back to the Future 3? Doesn't make much sense. I want a koi pond so bad, can't wait till I have my own place. Well, you should stay tuned to the channel, because I think we got... Well, where's the... I can't give out any teasers, so... Just stay tuned, that's all I'll say. Where is the Danio tank, Bob? It's at your house. Have you ever heard of a betta killing eating small pandacories? I got some and they disappeared after 2 days. Took everything out of the tank. Checked the filter media, found nothing. I guess it's possible. Pandacories, even at a small size. Oh my god, Bob is getting a pond. No, I'm certainly not getting a pond. I don't know, I would be really surprised. I feel like, is it possible for a betta fish to kill him? Yeah, but I don't think it would eat him. A fish was swimming and hit a concrete wall and said, damn. That's D-A-M, people. I'm not cussing. Josh, octopus plant from aquarium co-op. Yes, that can be a really fast grower. Pandacori have spines. They wouldn't be eaten whole. Yeah, that's so. I feel like if it's possible for the betta fish to kill them, but I don't think it would eat them. And Racing's Natural Aquariums agree with me, so I like it. I like when people that know more than me agree with me. Bob, series faces on. Better get back to my housework. Gotta keep that place nice for your fish. Our mod team is trying to get John Hudson back at it. Hasn't responded to us regarding the hobby, but he is alive, guys. He's just busy and taking a break. Yep, I do know that much. I do know that he is alive and well. And so, yeah. Maybe the pandacori jumped out. Maybe one, but I guess he didn't say how many he had. I don't think a betta would be able to eat a quarry fully. Yeah, I don't think so either. He could kill it, though. Cat or dog in the house? I have a husky shepherd mix. David Beckett Quartz Aquariums. I need to send you some floating plants. I throw away at least 3 pounds per week of floating plants. It's ridiculous. Yep. Absolutely. Floating plants grow fast. So was the April Fool's joke with the Rick a teaser for something? Nope, it was just that, an April Fool's joke. Heidi says, anyone know of a local fish stores in upstate New York? Yeah? Zachary says, yeah, I think that the pandacori jumped when they dash up to the surface to gulp air. They shoot up really fast. I don't know, I don't feel like all of them would jump out. Do you have piranhas? Nope. Are they boring? I've never kept them, but I would imagine them to get pretty boring. At least that's the complaint I hear from other people who think it's going to be awesome to have piranhas, and then they realize they just sit there except when it's time to eat. Bob, has your dog tried to eat any of your fish? Nope, but she did eat an entire can of fish food one time. That kind of sucked. Tight lid on the tank, nothing found on the floor. Do you have snails? Do you have snails in your tank? They might have just died and got consumed by snails, possibly. I don't know. Piranhas basically stay in one place. They are boring. Piranhas are super boring. Yep. Bob, you should grow a Viking beard. I don't know. See, I've been growing this for like 8 months, so that would take a while. What's the highest pH tolerance of jungle valve? I have jungle valve growing in my Tanganyikan tank that's like 8.5 pH. Jungle valve actually grows in Lake Tanganyika, so it should be able to handle pretty high pH. Clown loach food. My first dog was a husky shepherd mix, looked like a black wolf. They're awesome dogs. Bob, I'm sending you the scene I'm referring to. Well, yeah, I just did this last week, so give me a solid week and I can have a bag full for you. Mr. Science Geek, is anyone in here, have any fish recommendations that stay small and would eat guppy coals? Probably epistogrammas. Almost any dwarf cichlid. What product do you use to harden your water? I use Seachem salts. We had a husky wolf mix. He was handsome but a jerk to everyone but us. Yeah, mine is not. Well, I don't know what you think a jerk is, but mine is definitely very protective of the house, which is awesome. I highly promote it. Not that Bob, aquarium plants. Hi, can ghost shrimp eat bloodworms? I've never tried it, but they would probably try to eat them. I'm in the process of setting up a dope individual. Says I'm in the process of setting up a Tanganyikan tank. What live plants do you recommend? I just do jungle val and anubias. That's it. I haven't had success with much else. I had a full-size bronze quarry die in my 75. Never noticed no spikes. Only found out when moving stuff around. I found what was left of his skull. Nothing else. Bob, does crushed coral ever stop buffering? It'll eventually stop and it'll eventually just dissolve. Both my dogs are jerk. They hate everyone and everything but me. See, I like those kind of dogs. Keep all the people out. My mono shrimp eats bloodworms. Yes, a mono shrimp will eat everything. They'll even eat Neocardinia shrimp. If you had to become one fish, what would it be? Probably a puffer. How much would an albino pleco go for? Depends on the size. So a smaller one would be about $10. Adults usually go between 20 and 40 depending on color, size, things like that. Even my cherry shrimp eats bloodworms. Yeah, so definitely go shrimp would. All right, folks, we got 5 more minutes. The freshwater diversitin. What are good tropical fish? All tropical fish are good. That's a really broad question. I sell my albinos for $5 in-store credit. That's a really good deal. I thought Eddies looked nice, but I didn't get very often. The park, 45-minute drive. Can Marsilia quadrifolia attach and grow on wood? I don't know if it can or not, but I've never seen it. Most fun fish to watch. I really enjoy rainbow fish and Cyprochromis. There's a reason why I love them so much. Shrimp are the best tropical fish. Yep. How much are bushy-nosed plecos? Like I said, it depends on the color, the size. Way too many variables. They can be as cheap as $10 and as much as $50. Probably even more. Some of them are like $100, so yeah. What's the light green plant behind you? Baby tears. Baby tears is right here. Oops, right here. Can't even point there. this one. 5 pounds of cooked shrimp. Sounds pretty good to me. Makes walking dogs so stressful. Oh, see, my dog is only protective of my house and my car. So, yeah, I guess that would be a different scenario. When I take my dogs on walks, it's not a problem at all. Steam Fun Aquatics, how many has Brosis? Is too many for a 20-gallon? Man, I feel like you could do, well, 20 long or 20 tall. Like a 20 long, I feel like you could probably do at least 20. Are baby tears root or water column feeders? They are both, but probably water column feeders generally. 2-inch albino bristlenose plecos goes for $4 here. That's pretty good. What's more profitable, super red or green dragon plecos? Longfin green dragons sell for more. Green dragon plecos are pretty cheap. I don't even consider them like a normal fin green dragon pleco. Like, I feel that's not anything special. Like, green dragon, it has to have the long fins. I don't know, maybe I'm just stuck up when it comes to my bristlenose plecos, but I don't know that one is more profitable than the other, to be honest. What options for a Betta 20-gallon cleaner other than plecos? Well, I have shrimp with my Bettas with no problems, so maybe shrimp. What type of guppies do I have outside? They are Russian Red Delta guppies. I really like avocado plecos. Okay, so back to me lurking. I will be doing a water change on my 65-gallon. Good night, my friends. Bob is a bristlenose elitist. Yep, I guess so. I can't grow my super reds fast enough. Yeah, super reds are super, super duper popular right now. Definitely. Is there anyone besides Greg Sage who is really pushing longfin green dragons? I mean, I have a local breeder here that sells a ton of them. But he's probably the most known. Does Greg Sage take credit cards or PayPal? I have no idea. His website is Select Aquatics, and I'm sure it would tell you there, Rurutu. But offhand, I don't know. What shrimp will get along with ghost shrimp? Most Neos. Sunless Plain says clown plecos are the best. I don't know that they're the best, but they're super awesome. My oldest pleco is a clown pleco. Alright, so that's going to do it for tonight, folks. I went 15 minutes extra since I was 5 minutes late. Gave me an extra 10 minutes. I want to thank all the super chatters. Let's see, we got Born to Keep Fish, Fish Boss Man, Susan for SLC Aquatics, Bookshelf Aquatics, and LG3 Nation. Thanks everyone for the super chats. Like I said, we appreciate it. And yeah, not much else is going on around here. I definitely thank everyone for showing up and chatting. It was a lot of fun. Thanks to all my mods for doing mod stuff, even though it was pretty civil tonight. I don't think we had any trolls tonight. Did we have any trolls tonight? I don't think so. But yeah, hopefully I'll see everyone on Monday. Same fish time, same fish channel. Until then, everyone have a good weekend.